First of all, I want to thank Maureen for the time, and I want to first say that I am supporting this motion. Today, in conjunction with this motion, a seed has been sown. Sown by the quiet people in rural Ireland, where the beef plan movement have got people together to come to this city when at a time of year they would be at silage or hay or at other work. They have given their time, people from all parts of the country, to show their disgust at what's going on in the farming sector, not alone the Mercosur, but on what we're talking about in here. I've listened to it the last while. Everyone is talking about climate. And fine, in the last 3 weeks we have talked, we have seen a document that is going to screw these farmers €15 on every 100 when they go to make their silage or hay. A time when the factories are abusing farmers. A time when farmers are on the cap, the way they're being treated is disgusting. And Brexit around the corner. And now the final kick in the teeth was what the EU have decided to do on the Mercosur deal. 7 or 8 years ago, or 10 years ago, when this country was on its knees, we were damn glad to rely on the agricultural sector of €3.5 billion of exports going out in the beef sector. But then when our country starts getting better, and everyone welcomes that, they seem to be the forgotten people at the moment. Instead, we are going to go to a country, do a deal with them, that first of all has no traceability, second of all has high amounts of TB, thirdly have proved that they have sold rotten meat to other countries. And when you look at what they are cutting down, a football pitch every minute, and this is all in the name of climate change, that we are going to do this. We are going to haul it half array around the world, no more than what we're doing with some of our biomass. And we think that that's good. Europe is trying to kick out some of these types of systems the way that they'll be the clean, clean area and they'll look at everyone else. People talk about Mercs for meat. Well, the first thing we need to do before we talk about climate is talk about people, talk about families, talk about livelihoods, talk about living, talk about communities, and talk about areas in rural Ireland that need to survive. The areas where 100,000 farmers rely on the beef sector, where families, some of them work, but an awful lot of farmers put bread and butter on the table, not alone for their families, but also for the shopkeeper down the road, the butcher down the road, the local hardware merchant. That's what we must remember. This isn't just about the 100,000. What are we going to do? Make a theme park out of the west of Ireland, or indeed the rest of Ireland, because we're the green, clean economy, and let someone else produce the stuff. There seems to be an agenda driven by Europe that will plant a lot of this country, that will forget about the type of farming. But we must remember, we are heading into Brexit. We are looking at maybe borrowing €5 billion in our next budget. We are looking at people that could end up, through Brexit and through this deal, of not having a livelihood. And if you haven't a livelihood, you are not contributing to an economy, then you will need funding. I've heard in the last few days them talking about the great fund Phil has got, €1 billion. €1 billion that's going to save 27 countries in the whole of Europe. Well, let's remember that our exports in beef alone are over €3 billion. So Phil can shove his €1 billion where the sun doesn't shine, because it will not save our beef industry. We need to put a floor under it. We need to get real. We need to believe that people are more important in our country than winking and nodding to other bureaucrats in Europe that go out and do deal. We've to stand up for our people in each part of the country, and now is their hour of need. I've heard people saying we need to look at how it will go over the next few years. Well, our MEPs and our council of ministers and everyone around this house needs to stand together as Irish people and fight for farm families once and for all.
Thank you. You're out of time.